This conference will now be recorded.
Cat space greater than space, write a file name. Suppose this is a first. So this is a first of all I'm creating. One greater than symbol means you are creating the file. Cat space greater than space file name. That is a first. Now you can type the test. You can say, okay, this is a my first programming file. So hello to Linux world. And at end of the, how to terminate this prompt? Simply to save this file. Simply you save this file. Just type that Control plus D. It's important one. To save this file, we should type that Control plus D. Then you will, you feel like that the file was saved like that. See, here simply, remove this one. I'm pressing the Control plus D. What will happen here? Control plus D means that a file was saved here. So see here, how first one we are creating a file. How to see the information of that particular file? Second option, already I said that. So using the same cat command, we can also display the information. Simply you type the cat without any greater than symbol. Next, cat space, type the file name, that is the first. The information will be displayed here. So this is a first programming file. And hello to the world. So we can't edit here. Just for display, there is no symbol between cat after just a space and then file name. Now my next target is how to append the test to the existing file. Now existing file is nothing but first file. So how to append the test to existing file? Simply you type cat space two greater than symbols. There is no space between them, and write the file name and enter. So already we have two lines. Now again I am, it is a Red Hat only, Rohin Raina. Yes, at the end of the session you can ask that questions. So please complete the session, then after I give you the some time, then you can ask anything. Okay, next, how to append the test to the already existing file? So this is a, sorry, this is a third line of the first file. And next, hello, where are you? So okay, enough. I'm saving this one, Control T. Yes, now which output you are expecting? The lines will come only, are already existing two lines plus these two lines will come. What is your expecting? Now I think this is three lines are there. Yeah, three lines are there. What are your expectations for the output? Only these three lines will come. Are this first of all two lines, then after these three lines will come. Yes, so we are see here cat, just how to see that file of the information. So just cat space file name is the first. So see here, what is happening here? So first already two lines is there, then after we are appended some test to that existing file, we got the remaining three lines. I hope you all of you understand this one. Yes, first and second both will come. So just for the cat, we are for creating the files only. Only files. You must know the difference between the files and the directories. Okay, next one, how to know where I am? Suppose in your Windows we can easily find out where. Suppose I am, just see here, I am in D drive. How do we know? Just here we can say, oh, now we are at D drive. Suppose I'm opening another file, E drive. We are at E drive. Like that, how to know which, where I am arrived, which location I am exist? How to know that concept? We have a second option, that is a PWD, is a one another, which, so PWD is a another option. What is a PWD mean? That is nothing but present working directory, present working directory. When you type this command, you will get that where is a working location. So simply type PWD, definitely you will get where we are located. /root. Just see, before going to this one, I have to plan to explain one thing. So what is this tilde symbol? What is the tilde? Already I explained the root is a user, and IP is nothing but host name, and we have the tilde symbol is there. This is a default directory of the home root user. So see here, if you want which files are here, you can simply type that ls, listing the files. Ls means you will get that all the directories for the root user. Ls means listing that directories. Ls means which files are there in that, in the what is that, C from in C languages we have the command, I think command only, no, C, what is the CMD command. So in the C language, your Windows, so suppose how many files are there in our Windows system, in the DOS we are using the DIR directory, then we will get that all the information of the directories or files of the D drive. Like that in a Linux also, how to find the which folders, which files are exist in that one, simply you type that ll or ls. Ls also we will get. So ls, suppose you want the complete information of that present working directory, simply type ll, listing the files, you will get that in a order. So what is the file? See, blue colors are there, that are the folders, means directories. Black colors are the files. These all are the files. So these are the blue colors, all are the folders. Folders may contain again subfolders, may have the files. So next, next command is a cat is over. Cat is for using the three types. That is the first one. First one to create a file and display the file information, and third one is append the test at end of the line. At the same time, we are using the second command also. Already explained to you, this first one is over. Second one, we are using that pwd. So pwd is the present working directory. And third one, ls. Listing that listing the files. Ls means which folders are there in that particular location, we can simply type ls. Okay, next one we will discuss deeply about the ls option. Now see here, what is a base, what is a main directory in a Linux system? Anybody give that answer? What is a main root directory? What is a root directory? Please, anyone give a reply. What is the main directory? Under that one, we have that all subdirectories. Yes, Rahul Reddy said right one only. That is a root directory, root directories, forward slash. So simply how to go to that particular location, just type that cd and which location, slash, forward slash. Then you will go to particular directory. Here already we there. We are at root directory. It's clear. Cd space and forward slash. Now we are landed at pwd, present working directory, where I am at root, is a base main directory for the remaining all directories. Now my intention is, what is a subfolders of this root directory? So we can type ls or ll, both are same. Ll means you are getting the listing. So already we have discussed bin is there, and boot, data, dev, etc, home, all these files already this we are discussed, almost all the folder. Some are blue color, some are in a different color. This is a soft link, hard link. We have one concept is there, then you will get that information. Just think about the blue color files. This is a directories. These are all these are, this is are the soft link files. Soft link, yes, definitely the starting letter will be started with L. See here, how to find out which is directory, which is a file? At the same time, I will create a file in the root directory. See here. Now I will create a file, cat. Suppose same file. What is the second? I create a file that is a second. Sorry, cat creation should be use a greater symbol. That is a second. Okay, this is a Linux world. Just I'm saving for Control D. And just I press the Control D. Over. See here. Now I want to know the what is the files under. Now where I have actually just type the pwd, present working directory is a root directory. Now I want to which subfolders are exist in this root directory. Simply you type ls or ll. See here, what I done here, just I created a file. See here, now I created a file that is a, see here, this is a, just now I created, the file name is a second. Observe here, only this file is in the color of black. Black means it's a file. Is this blue is nothing but directory. So first of all, we have, this is a permission, first one. And you know the inode value is there. Every file should have one value, that is a inode value. I am only explaining now here. Actually, we have one concept here, notepad. In Linux, every file should have the one value, that is a inode value. Why? Because we know the root value and we are saying this is a bin, but system does not know that what is a boot, what is a data dev. So that's why the Linux system give that one value for either that is a file, that is either file or directory, that is giving you one value that we are calling inode values. These are, by using this inode, the Linux machine will find out which is a suppose bin, which is a boot. Just this value for this alphabet, this words are for the human readable, but system, the machine does not understand this language. The system simply understand by using that inode values. So here these are, the second one is a inode values. First one is a permission. We have one concept is there, permissions. Next one is user grouped. I will tell you later. Now it is a size of that particular file. Now just we have created second. What is the size? That is a 20 KB. And creation date and file name. Is it clear to all of you? Just simply remember, we have one concept for the permissions. We will discuss these two things. And this is a inode value of the, every file should have one inode value, unique inode value. And this is a what is that, owner of the file, group of the file, and size of the file, creation time, and file name. This is about the files under the root. Suppose I want to go to I am planning to move to one folder. What is that folder here? I want to move to proc directory. How to go to, just type that cd space proc. Just how to move to that directory, particular directory, cd space proc, enter. Now see here where you are, simply type pwd. So we are at under slash, we are at the folder proc. Now I want to know which files are exist in this folder or directory. Simply type ll. So ll, see here you have number of system related files. Yes, wait, we have number of pages are there. Yes, all these are different directories. D starts with, D means it's a directory. Only with one file is this. So suppose see here, this is no, there is no D, no L, only slash is this. Slash is nothing but it is a file. Just wait. Okay. So now next one, just how to go to back. Now we came to forward. Just to type cd space dot dot. Just move to one step back. Now where we are now? See here, pwd. Now it, we are root directory. How to go to forward? Cd space proc. Now observe here where we are now, at proc, forward slash proc. How to come to outside of that particular folder? Cd space dot dot. You will come to outside of the directory. Okay, this is about the present working directory and how to move to cd is there. Cd command will be used for go to particular folder or someone message. Just I will give the clarity of end of the session. You can ping the doubts at the end of the session only, please. Yes, I will explain to you read, write, execute to permission. Santosh, I will explain you. We have a particular session at the time. Just we are at basics commands only. At the time of the explanation, then I will definitely how to give the read group owner. I will explain each and everything. Don't worry about that one. Okay, next one. We go to the next command, that is a search command. This is the next one. So touch command also used to see here. You can easily understand by practical. See here, I'm creating a file here at this location, that is a third. Hi. And I control D means here. Next, I use the touch, I create the fourth. Please concentrate at here. Now I will listing that all the files. What will happen? Just I created, that is a third. Where is it? Is third. Yes. Now again I type, that is a fourth. What is the major difference here? By using the two commands, touch, both are files only. First of all, see here, fourth black color. It is a here. It is a flash only. It is a file, and third also file. What is the major difference between them? Maybe it is inter question. What is the difference between cat command and touch command? Simply, cat command is using for three purposes: for creation, for display, and last one is appending the test. But touch command is only used for creation of the empty files. Please note that. So touch command, by using the touch command, we cannot enter. It is not possible to enter the test to the created file. But cat command, we can create and we can enter the test. So that is a difference. Only touch command is used for. Touch command is only for. It creates the files. Which files? That is the empty files. And one more example. See here. By using the touch command, you can create 100 or 1000 files at a one step. See here. Touch and creating, that is a Linux. And open it. So 1 to 100 I'm giving. So what is the meaning here? So the files, the touch is used for only for creating empty files. Now I will create a 100 file. Not only 100, you can give the 1000 also, not a problem. So the files look like touch space Linux and open bracket and 1 to 2 dots only. Don't give more than 2, 1 to 100. So see what will happen. So I will give the LS and I will give simply LS. It is easy to see how many files are created here. So 100 files are created with only one step. So this is another use. So we can create only empty files by using the touch command, but it is not possible with the cat command. Okay, how to create, how to enter the data to this existing file? Simply again, you have to use the cat command only. See here, cat and append the test, which is Linux one. Hi, and control D, over. Yes, see here, cat Linux one. So for what is the use of the touch command? Touch command is simply for creating the empty files. And second one is we can again enter the data or any information to the files which are created by the touch command, should use again cat command only. So one more use also there, but I will explain at the time of the we have that groups and permission. At that time I will explain that what is another use of the touch command. Okay, next one we will see. How to, now till now we have discussed about only the files only. Now my question is, how to create a folder. Folder is nothing but in our Windows language we are saying that is a folder, but in our Linux language we have to call that is a directory. How to create a directory? See here, simply use the make directory, mkdir, make directory. Yes, so you are right only. Make directory and directory name, suppose that is a ABC. CFLL. Okay, we have a lot of files are there. Just we clear it. So 1 minute. So So now my, what is I created here? ABC, yes, now see here. So first one, I created a file that is a ABC, which is a first letter of that permissions is a D means directory. L means is a linking, soft link file. Only slash is there, that is a normal file, which is in the black color. Okay, now I want to go to that particular ABC directory. How do it is possible? Now where I am? Root. I want to go to, in the root folder, I have a one sub directory is there. In root, I have a one just created one directory is there, that is a ABC. How to go to that particular directory? So simply I said to you, yes, cd space and what is the file? ABC. So see here, nothing is there, that's why. See here, now where we are? PW at ABC. Anything is there? Nothing. So now my plan is again in this one. Actually, my plan is like, see here, first one in we are at root, again we have created ABC. ABC. My plan is next, I have in this ABC folder, I am going to create two folders. Suppose that is a first and last folder name. In this folder, I will create a file. That is my target. So see for that one. So first one I created, already root is there, where we are, here PWD. Root ABC is created. Now in this ABC folder directory, I want to create two directories. That is a first MKDR, that is a first folder. Okay. Second one MKDR and last directories. Next one, I'm going to create a file in the first directory. That's why we have to go to directory first of all. So that one we are using the CD. So what is the directory name? First. And then after anything is there, just type the ls, nothing is there. So now I'm going to create a file. So that is a cat space greater than space, and that is a a dot a, file name is here. See here, I will type here. Here this is a, so this is a file of first directory. Okay, and control D. Yes, now where we are? ABC folder, in that again for that directory, don't use the folder that you call that is a directory. ABC directory, again one subdirectory is there, that is a first. In that sub first, what we have? We have one file is there, that is a file name is a. Now I want to go to another folder. So first of all, I go to ABC, then only I will create another one is a last folder. So that's why I said CD dot dot. Just we go to just one step back. So where we are now? At ABC. Now here again I create another folder, that is a make directory, that is a last. Again I go to already, what is that? Already we are created, just I will see. Okay, first and last, both are we are created. Now I want to go to last folder directory. In this directory I will create a file, that is a cat space greater than space. I will create a file, that is a b. So this is a file of last directory. Okay, and control D, save this one. Control D for saving the file. Okay, see. Clear. So I come forward, just last, then again cd dot dot. I am at root. Now, what is waste? One minute. Sorry, DW, where we are now? Present working directory is a root. Now I want to which files are exist in the, what is the actual folder name? I think ABC, main folder, that is ABC. I want to know what is the subfolders of ABC. Simply type tree ABC. Okay, this command is not equal. Okay, thanks for Linux. Okay, just now I want to know that information about the ABC is folder there. Again, ABC has the some subfolders, and in subfolders again we have the some information. Now I want to know the total structure, which folders, which files are exist in ABC file. I want to know that one. Simply, I think ls minus recursive R for ABC. I will paste this one. I hope this one. Yes, right on. Ls minus listing the files, R means recursive, hyphen R, and should use that where the file is located, under root folder and the directory. Under root, we have under one folder is there, that is a ABC. So we get that one. First of all, we have in this one, we have the first and blue color means for that is a directory, first and last. Yeah. Then after in this one, we have the first, we have what is that? We file a file that is a A, and in the last we have the another file is a B. I think all of you understand this is some useful file. So using only one command, we will get that what is a under one folder, which files are, which files directs are exist, subdirects, we will get that only using the one command. I hope you all of you understand. Yes, Bano, it's a Linux basic session only. From here, some of them don't know the diary. What is a Linux? That's why I'm starting from basics only. Allowed, I clearly said, those who are advanced in this Linux, it is not useful. After 30 days, then all will get equal knowledge. Then all are equal. Then after, the advanced students are now intermediate students, then easily understand. Now new students also, they are getting little bit knowledge day by day only. They, in one day, they can't get the total knowledge. So that's why I started from the basics only. Okay, today, this is a today session. And what is a tomorrow session means? Main important concept is a VI editor. We are using that in a Windows. We are using that, what is that test notepad is there. Like that, for editing any files, we are using the one note, like notepad, we have one editor is there. That is a VI editor, simply VI only. When you type the VI, we will get that editor. So suppose VI, space here. I will explain tomorrow how to use this one. Just wait. So this is about the today's session, and tomorrow same time we will discuss that VI editor. Then after we go to the permissions for the groups, files and directories. So then one by one. So this is the basics. Please try to get some more knowledge about the commands of the Linux. All commands explanation is not possible here, so that I telling you this word. Wait, I will say one more command to you. Wait, be on the line. Just wait. So we have created ABC folder. Now I'm creating one more folder. MPDF. Suppose DPF is another folder. LS. Now ABC is there. And next one is a DEF. DEF. Two folders. How to remove this one? Simply Rm minus Rf, and Rm means remove the directories of ABC, and R is a recursive, and F means is a forcefully we are deleting. Simply enter Rm, remove the files of that particular existing directory ABC. Now we are deleting Rm. Make directory means create, mkdir is a creating the directory. Rm means for removing the directory. We are using this R means recursive, means in that subfolders or anything files are there, if they are in under the opening position also, we are using F means forcefully we have to delete that one of ABC files. Now see here what is there again, ABC not there. Next Rm, what is the second one directory, that is a ABC. But no, not ABC, I think that is a DEF. So now see, yes. Now only that default directories are there. Okay, thank you for participating. Tomorrow we will see that. Yeah, tomorrow we have that one good session about the VM editor, VI editor, VIM editor. Both are there, both are same, only one is graphical is there. Next one is tomorrow after next class, after I think one day takes for the VM editor, then after we will see that groom permissions, and day after tomorrow is a actual administration level concept we will discuss. Okay, I will provide this video to the group, but give 1 hour time. Okay, thank you for the participation. So you have any doubts, I will add to that WhatsApp group for 1 hour. You can ping the doubts and don't misuse that group. Thank you.